Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at using keyboard shortcuts to help you fill in web forms. So keyboard shortcuts depend upon the context. For instance, you're going to have different sets of keyboard shortcuts working in Photoshop than you are working in, say, Pages. Now, if you're filling out a web form, there's a bunch of standard shortcuts that don't even involve the command key. But knowing them will help you fill out forms quicker, especially if it's something you have to do a lot. Now, as an example, I'm going to use this feedback form at the Apple website. It's the feedback form for Apple TV. I've chosen it because there's lots of different form elements in it. So right away, we can see that there's several different fields where you just type text into. Now, to move back and forth between those fields, I can take my mouse and click in one. I can click in this one, I can click in that one. I can move around in any order I want to. But what's more interesting is being able to do it with the keyboard. And the key to use for movement between fields is the Tab key. If I hit the Tab key once, I'll go from this field to the next one. And then the next one after that. If I just hit the Tab key again, Shift Tab goes the opposite direction. So I can Shift Tab back and hit those two fields back again. So I can move back and forth very freely between fields. If I type in one and move to the next one, I can see I can go back to it. And inside of a field, of course, I can use the arrow keys to move the cursor back and forth. So I never really have to move my hand over to the trackpad or to the mouse to go between these fields. Now, if I continue to press Tab, I'll move down and the form will scroll with me. So you can see it will scroll down to the next element, which is a pop-up menu. So pop-up menu, I could use the mouse and click on it and then select one with the cursor. But you can see it's selected. It has the blue outline around it. I can hit the space bar and it will show me the selections in there and then use the arrow keys up and down to hover over one and then hit the space bar again to select it. And you can see everything still works with the Tab keys. I can do Shift Tab to go back, Tab to go forward, Tab to go to the next one, back again, space bar, move to select a new one, and space bar to select it. And in many cases, space bar, I can also use the return key. I'm just doing the return key right there to do it instead of the space bar. Now if I continue to Tab and go down here, I'll see that I have a set of radio buttons. I'm going to scroll up a bit so you can see them. And I can move back and forth between them with the Tab. You can see even though they're part of a set, yes and no, a Tab and Shift Tab go back and forth between them, a spacebar will select one. So I'm going to hit spacebar there and it'll select one. And spacebar won't turn it off again. And that's because the way you work with radio buttons is you have to switch to the other one. So I'm going to switch over here to no, hit spacebar. And I can Shift Tab back and go back and forth between them. So that's how you work those. Now to work the checkboxes that you see below, these I just do the same thing. I do Tab and Shift Tab to go back and forth, spacebar to select one. I can do spacebar again to unselect one. And then I've got another pop-up menu here. I can select with the spacebar, then arrow keys, and then spacebar. And I can continue to move on to the next items down here and select with the spacebar, moving back and forth with Shift Tab. When I get to the end, you can see I've got a Submit Feedback button here at the end of this form. That's part of the form, the button. Now as far as being able to hit the Submit Feedback button, some forms allow you to go from this last element here and Tab down and it will highlight the Submit Feedback button, while others will not. Depends how the page is coded. So in this case, it's just going to jump up to the field at the top, which is this search field here, and then I can continue and go through the form again. Sometimes there's scripting on a web page that kind of gets in the way of this. It tries to help you, but it gets in the way. So for instance, on this page here, you're asked to enter a phone number. And look what happens. When I start entering the area code, as soon as I hit the third digit of the area code, it immediately jumps to the second field, which is fine and nice if you're just going to type 10 digits. But if I'm not looking and then I hit Tab, like I expect to go to the next field, you can see it jumps me to the third field. What's worse is if I hit Shift Tab to go back and then back here, it immediately jumps forward because it already sees there's three digits in there. So in order to get rid of that, if I made a mistake, I have to go in there manually with the mouse. And you can see now I can just type. And it works as long as I don't use the shortcuts. So sometimes it gets in the way and sometimes it doesn't, because I've seen the same thing coded many times where it operates correctly, it allowing you to enter in three digits and then you can hit Tab, or if you start typing the fourth digit, it jumps automatically to the next field. So when filling out a form for the first time, you have to be careful using the keyboard shortcuts to make sure everything is working properly. But where this really comes in useful is if you have a job where you have to enter in information into a form all the time. And it's the same basic form or set of forms, and you get to use the keyboard shortcuts to make your work go a little bit faster. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.